Good evening, guys, and welcome to another session in which we will be covering the deposit insurance law. But before anything else, let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord as we pray the Louisian prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, wellspring of goodness and blessings, we give you thanks and praise as one Louisian community. The graces you incessantly grant upon us and your divine providence have sustained our beloved university throughout the years of mission and excellence. Having been founded by the Congregation of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, we pray that you keep us committed and dedicated to our mission and identity to serve the Church and the society as we become living witnesses to the gospel values proclaimed by Jesus. For if we are steadfast in our good and beautiful mission, our works will bring success not only to ourselves, but also to those whom we are bound to love and to serve. Inspired by St. Louis, our patron, who was filled with a noble spirit that steered him to love you above all things, may we also live believing that we are born for a greater purpose and mission, as we dwell in your presence all the days of our life. Grant all these supplications through the intercession of Mother Mary and through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Once again, good evening, everyone. And as mentioned, tonight we will be discussing about the deposit insurance law. This is covered by the charter of the PDIC, or the Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation. And it is covered in the Republic Act 3591 as amended. And the latest amendments came in 2016 via RA 10846, signed into law by the former President Noynoy Aquino. So, what is the intention of the lawmakers in coming up with this law? They are trying to protect, you know, the rights of the depositors, okay? Because there is a possibility that banks will be closed, okay? And if that happens, where are the depositors going to recover their deposits, okay? So, saan sila lalapit para mabawi yung kanilang deposit? Siyempre, we cannot deny that people, since they have very high confidence in the banking system, they place their entire trust in that system, and they avail of the services of the bank. One of which is yung pagkakaroon ng mga deposit accounts. And, yun nga. Although we do not want that to happen, the lawmakers are just preparing for a contingency. What if that happens? Ano mangyayari? Okay, so yun nga. Account holders in banks, syempre, hard-earned money nila yung nilalagay nila sa banko. Lalong-lalo na dun sa mga small na depositors, which actually, this law tries to protect the most, no? Okay, and ayun na nga. What happens in case mabankrupt ang isang banko and the bank will not have anything to give out, no? Parang what if nalugi sila, wala na silang ipambabayad, hindi na nila maibabalik yung mga deposits, what is going to happen? Paano naman yung mga deposits? Ganun na lang ba yun? Mawawala na lang ba yun? Okay, so this law tries to cover that. Okay, tries to prepare for that contingency. What if all of these things happen? Okay? And if we are to look at it, okay, itong batas na ito, sa on a bird's eye view, gusto lang naman natin tingnan, okay, insurance yan eh. Just like yung mga ordinary insurance na alam natin, okay, life and non-life insurance, syempre, hindi naman lahat covered. Kaya nga, kayo, kung naranasan na ninyong kumuha ng mga insurance policies ninyo, maraming chine-check. Okay? Kasi nga, the nature of insurance is yun nga, the assumption of risk. And what the PDIC assumes is yung risk na baka in the future magsara ang banks and hindi sila makakapagbayad. Okay? So the PDIC will take over these banks na nagsara and they will assume the risk, no, of paying out the liabilities of a closed bank. So ganun naman ang mga insurance eh. The nature of insurance is the assumption of risk and therefore kailangan ano eh, hindi nila i-maximize. Kailangan lahat naman eh. Okay? Dapat i-minimize natin ang risk. Okay? There is this concept which we call risk appetite wherein ito lang yung threshold ng kaya nating i-assume na risk. So we must place yung level of risk under that risk appetite ng isang company. So if for example, an insurance company meron lang siyang risk level na ganito, risk appetite na ganitong level, they will have to check, okay, whether for example, life insurance ang ino-offer para ma-minimize yung risk. Okay, kailangan ang i-insure lang natin yung mga healthy lang. Okay? Kasi kung i-insure natin kahit yung mga gustong kumuha ng insurance sa atin na may sakit na, edi lalaki yung ano natin, yung risk, tataas yung risk. Okay? And we will be more susceptible with ano, paying out. Mas magiging susceptible tayo sa pag-disburse ng funds which we do not like. Okay? Kasi yun nga, an insurance company is also a business entity and therefore gusto niyang mag-business, kumita. Okay? So paano natin i-minimize or paano minimize ng mga insurance companies yung risk? Yun na nga, by accepting or by going through a rigorous screening. Okay, hindi lahat ng mga nag-a-apply ng insurance pinagbibigyan. Okay? So pero dito kasi sa PDIC, you will know later, you will find out later that membership is mandatory. Okay? Pero syempre, naglalagay pa rin sila ng level of ng limit. Okay? Familiar na sa inyo by now na ang maximum insurance per depositor per bank is 500,000. We will discuss that later. Okay? Okay, so much for the introductions, no? Yun nga. After we have learned kung sino yung mga... Kasi in the concept of insurance, kailangan natin malaman sino ba yung mga covered. Okay? Hindi naman lahat i-cover. Okay? After natin malaman kung sino yung mga covered, sino yung mga hindi, magpo-focus tayo dun sa mga covered. Okay? Now, what will be the requirements of these covered people? Okay, yung scope, okay, ng ating deposit insurance. Kailangan nating malaman kung ano ba yung requirements na kailangan nilang i-fulfill. And then kasabay niyan, we will also discuss how to compute, 'di ba? Paano ba natin ko-computein how much is insured? Okay, meron nga tayong maximum na 500,000, pero we will try to catch as many situations as possible mamaya. Okay, in our discussion. So, to start, okay, the PDIC, kailangan muna natin malaman ano ba yung PDIC. And the PDIC stands for the Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation. And by virtue of Republic Act 3591, it was established in 1963. Okay? RA 3591, which is yung very first. But actually, until now, there are still some provisions of RA 3591 that is still useful. Although it has gone through series of amendments na just like your Anti-Money Laundering Act. Okay? Meron pa rin naman. And the charter of the PDIC still includes RA 3591 as amended. Okay? And yun nga, it is RA 3591 that created the PDIC and gave it its powers. Although, yung powers niya, yung scope niya, and other things were, syempre, amended as time went on. Okay? Public policy objectives. What were the lawmakers thinking nung ginawa nila tong batas na ito? Okay, number one, to promote and to safeguard the interests of the depositing public by way of providing insurance coverage on all insured deposits. Pero malalaman natin mamaya, how are we going to determine which deposits are insured, which deposits are not? Okay? Pero one thing na kailangan ninyong malaman, basta insured, basta ma-meet mo yung definition ng insured deposit, then you will be provided insurance coverage, okay, on all insurance insured deposits. Okay? And yun na nga, number one, to safeguard the interests. Okay? Number two, to strengthen the mandatory deposit insurance coverage system. Okay? Yun na nga, since it is very important that depositors get back their deposits as much as they can. Okay, kasi syempre there might be some deposits na hindi ma-recover entirely. Okay, pero as much as they can recover, they must recover. So to strengthen that, eto, andito yung RA 3591 as amended. Okay? Itong Philippine Deposit Insurance Law. Okay, number three, to generate, preserve, and maintain faith and confidence in the country's banking system. Without deposit insurance kasi, syempre, parang ang pagde-deposit sa banko is now going to become parang gambling eh. Hindi mo na alam kung pwedeng lumago yung pera mo because of interest, although napakaliit lang because yung default na interest natin is 1/4 of 1% per annum. Okay, 0.25%. Okay? Alam mo yung 1%, kunin mo ang 1/4 nun, then that's just the interest that you get per annum. Plus, you have learned in your taxation na na may final tax na 20%, di ba? Imposed on deposits, di ba? Depende na lang kung FCDU or EFCDS, di syempre there is a different rate. Pero for local deposits, domestic deposits, then 20% lang. So 1/4 of 1% ang interest, babawasan pa yun ng 20% final tax. So for those who have online banking, mapapansin naman ninyo yan, you open your banking applications and then tingnan ninyo yung monthly na nakikredit. Lagi yan eh, monthly, may makikredit tapos merong nababawas in the same day. Makikredit yung interest, mababawas yung tax. And you will find out that na yung tax is 20% of what was credited sa inyo, na barya-barya lang. Okay? So, yun na nga, if because of deposit insurance, hindi na siya nagiging gamble. Kasi kung wala yung deposit insurance, it's either you gain through interests or you lose. Kasi nga, pwedeng mabankrupt yan, pwedeng mawala. Okay? And then, because of deposit insurance, na-eliminate yung yung risk na mag-close yung bank. Hindi ka na natatakot mag-deposit because iniisip mo na hala baka magsara. Kasi even if magsara yung banko, andiyan ang PDIC. Okay? And then yun na nga, because of that, the faith and the confidence of the people in the banking system of our country is increased. Okay? And lastly, to protect it from illegal schemes and machinations. So, meron kasing inintroduce dito sa PDIC yung unsafe and unsound banking practices. And there will be consequences if a bank covered by or governed by the BSP and mandatorily insured by the PDIC is engaging in these unsafe and unsound banking practices. So, kung ma-find out, syempre, corrective action will be undertaken. If not, then there will be consequences. What is the mandate? Okay, anong kailangan gawin ng PDIC? Ano ba yung kanilang trabaho? What are they here for? Okay, number one, deposit insurance. Okay, syempre, in cases wherein magsasara ang banko, at least andyan ang PDIC to give out, to pay out, okay, insurance doon sa mga, to pay out yung insured amounts. Okay? Kasi, again, lalo na for big deposits, hindi lahat talaga marerecover. Okay? Pero at least may marerecover. Okay? And, yun nga, that's the mandate of the PDIC, which is to insure each depositor, okay, and yun nga, against the risk of closure ng mga banko. Okay, and what is the maximum deposit coverage? As you can see on your screens, 500,000 per depositor per bank. Okay, So, paano nga ba nagkakaroon ng pera yung PDIC? Okay? Merong deposit insurance fund na tinatawag, and that is 20% or 0.2% of the total deposit liabilities. Okay? Ano ba ibig sabihin ng total deposit liabilities? Well, as you have learned in your obligations and contracts, no, ang yun nga, the relationship between the bank and the bank and a account holder is that of hindi siya deposit actually, kasi ang deposit in civil law is yun nga, you're going to place a thing, okay, ibibigay mo ang isang thing sa isang depositary, okay, for safekeeping until masettle yung mga claims on that thing. Okay, like for example, merong mga maraming taong nag-aaway sa isang movable property kasi ang immovables hindi sila pwedeng subject ng contract of deposit. So kapag may movable, ilalagay yan sa isang depositary, and then the depositary has the obligation to safekeep yung thing na yun until ma-settle yung disputes. Okay? If you are a debtor and yun nga, yung thing na ibibigay mo, maraming nagke-claim, eh hindi mo alam kung kanino magbabayad, kung dun sa isa bang nagke-claim o dun sa isa, i-deposit mo na lang. Okay, that's deposit as far as civil law is concerned, no? Pero yung deposit na alam natin, yung layman term na deposit na alam natin, that's actually a simple loan or mutuum. Okay, yun yung corresponding na contract niya kung ang context na gagamitin natin would be obligations and contracts. Okay? And yun nga, simple loan or mutuum siya, and then therefore there is a debtor-creditor relationship between the bank and the account holder. So the account holder, upon opening an account, nag-agree naman yung banko. Yun nga, it creates a debtor-creditor relationship. The debtor is the bank, the creditor is the account holder. Kasi magbibigay ka ng pera, eh. Parang inutang siya ng banko. Okay? What is the obligation? Kasi debtor yung bank. The obligation is to return yung deposit. Okay? So, that is why there is a liability. Okay? May obligation ang isang banko na bayaran yung account holder niya because of the contract of simple loan or mutuum. And whatever money meron ang isang banko, all of that liability niya dun sa mga respective account holders niya. And whatever is the liability, okay, for a year, 0.2% of that is going to be their payment, mandatory payment yan ng banko doon sa PDIC. Okay, so medyo ability to pay pa rin siya kasi percentage siya, eh. Kaya hindi naman siya fixed rate. I mean, hindi naman siya fixed amount. Okay? The rate is fixed. Okay? That's 0.2%. Pero, syempre, it depends pa rin doon sa deposits na meron ng isang banko. Okay? Second mandate is, yun nga, the receivership of closed banks. And, ano ba yung receivership? Receivership is, yun nga, in a receivership, there is a person who is going to, parang, binibigyan siya ng ano eh, ng responsibility. The bank, hindi bank. Kasi, yun nga, the PDIC is becoming, or is being made receiver, okay, of the closed bank. So, what do we mean when we say receiver? Receiver is the person or institution, okay, that is responsible, okay, for the property of as another person. So, for example, PDIC and the bank. The bank closes, therefore, all of its assets, all of its liabilities will be placed now under the responsibility of the receiver, which is PDIC. And upon takeover by the PDIC, okay, magpe-pay out na siya. Okay? It will now begin the liquidation process. Okay? It will try to realize yung kanyang non-cash assets for distribution, okay, sa mga creditors. Yung unang-una yung creditors. And gaya nga ng sabi ko kanina, the creditors primarily would be yung mga account holders. Okay? And maybe there are other creditors, pero syempre, creditor pa rin naman yun. Okay? Mabibigyan pa rin sila. Okay? makaka-receive pa rin sila ng payout from the PDIC. Okay? So, PDIC proceeds with the liquidation process upon order of the Monetary Board of the BSP. So, it is the Monetary Board which orders the closure of a bank. And upon order of the closure of the bank, PDIC now takes over. Okay? PDIC now receives the assets, the liabilities, okay, of a closed bank. Take over na siya. Okay? So, yun nga, the assets of the closed bank are managed and eventually disposed of. Okay, lalong-lalo na yung mga non-cash kasi syempre the account holders will not be interested to receive a safe, a chair, a computer. Syempre hindi. Syempre ang gusto nilang ma-receive would be money, di ba? So it is disposed of yung mga assets to settle claims of creditors in accordance with the preference and concurrence of credits as provided by the Civil Code of the Philippines. Yung obligations and contracts naman natin is under the Civil Code of the Philippines, particularly Book 4, no? So, and other credits, okay? Credit transactions that's still covered by the Civil Code, okay? So, yun. And actually, may third mandate pa yan, eh, yung ating PDIC. Pero, and that is, yun nga, co-regulator na rin siya ng banks. Although, it's primarily the BSP who regulates the banks. Pero because of a, I don't know, circular ba siya? I'm not sure. Basta there is a document released by the PDIC. Let me see, ano nga kaya yun? Ah, okay. That's the PDIC Regulatory Issuance 2011-01. And included in that issuance by the PDIC is yung tinatawag natin na unsafe and unsound banking practices. And yun na nga, the PDIC is the one who looks into this. Sila yung nagsasanction, okay, ng mga banks who do this, yung mga unsafe and unsound banking practices. Okay, kaya another mandate of the PDIC is yun nga, they are also co-regulator of banks. They also regulate, okay? Okay, who is or ano ang composition ng PDIC? Who composes the PDIC? Okay? The ex-officio chairman is the DOF secretary or the finance secretary. Okay, ex-officio chairman siya. Ibig sabihin, whoever sits as the finance secretary, automatic siya ang chairman ng PDIC. Okay? And then, there is who we call the PDIC president. Appointed siya by the president of the Philippines. Pero the president of the Philippines does not have authority to appoint anyone. Okay, it's the GCG who provides a shortlist to the president, and from that shortlist, mamimili ang presidente kung sinong i-appoint niya, okay, as the PDIC president. And once a PDIC president has been appointed, then he is automatically the vice chairman of the board. Okay, and then who are the members? The BSP governor is an ex-officio member. So, whoever is the BSP governor, automatic is siyang member ng PDIC. And then, there are 5 other members from the private sector. And again, just like the PDIC president, the GCG provides a short list, okay, to the president. And then, the president chooses from that short list kung sino yung magiging 4 na co-members ng BSP governor. So, there will be 1 chairman. So, 7 yan, ha? Okay. 1 chairman, 1 vice chairman, and then 5 members. And one of those members is the governor of the Banco Central. So, yun na nga. The PDIC president and the 4 members, other than the BSP governor, they are appointed by the president of the Philippines and chosen from a shortlist provided by the GCG or the Governance Commission for GOCCs. Okay, Governance Commission for GOCC, so GCG. Okay? So shortlist bibigay sa presidente, from that mamimili ang president, then ayan na. Okay? That's the composition. Okay? Okay, membership. On the point of view of the banks, do I have an option? If, for example, I'm going to open a bank, a small bank, pwede bang hindi na lang ako maisali? I mean, pwede bang I'll just assume the risk? Okay? Hindi na lang ako magbabayad ng annual dues ko sa PDIC and I'm not going to become a member bank of the PDIC. Is that allowed? Okay, of course, the answer is hindi pwede because sabi nga ng batas, membership with PDIC is mandatory for all the banks licensed by the BSP to operate in the Philippines. And who are banks that are licensed by the BSP to operate in the Philippines? Banks that are incorporated under Philippine laws. Okay? Meaning they are domestic corporations. Okay? Pwede bang resident foreign? Of course, pwede. And yan na yung domestic branches of foreign banks. HSBC, they have a branch here, no? Citibank, meron din. Deutsche Bank, andito rin. Okay? And other banks na foreign, okay? Na may branches dito sa Philippines. Okay, how about foreign banks na walang branch dito sa Pilipinas? Pero may mga Pilipinong may accounts doon. Okay, na naririnig ninyo kapag may mga mayayaman na politicians and they want to conceal yung cash nila, they go to Swiss banks, 'di ba? So covered kaya 'yon? These are foreign banks na walang branch sa Pilipinas but there are account holders or depositors who are Filipinos. Okay? The answer is hindi pwede. Okay, because they are not licensed by the BSP and therefore hindi rin sila covered ng insurance ng PDIC. Because they are not members. Hindi sila bibigyan ng membership ng PDIC. Okay? So, again, only those that are licensed by the BSP to operate in the Philippines, such as domestic banks and foreign banks with branches here in the Philippines. Okay, the scope of the deposit insurance is 500,000 per depositor per bank. Okay? But, it can go up until 1 million pesos. Okay? How? Mamaya, didiscuss natin. By the way, no, itong logo na ito, nakikita ninyo ito usually sa mga sa glass doors, okay, ng mga banks. Okay? Lagi nyo nakikita tong logo na to. And yun pa lang, if you remember this logo, if you remember these stickers placed outside the banks, okay, makikita ninyo that the maximum deposit insurance for each depositor 500,000 lang talaga. Pero pwede nga siyang maging 1 million which we will be explaining in a while. Okay? Who are covered? Okay, gaya nga ng sabi natin kanina, those that are domestic, okay, meaning incorporated under Philippine laws and foreign, although they are incorporated in the laws of other countries pero they operate here in the Philippines. They have some operations dito sa Pilipinas. So, ayan na. Siya na yung by currency. Hindi siya by currency. Basta yun. Okay? These are covered. They are covered. Yun yung mga banks na covered. Okay? And then, how about doon sa mga types of accounts? Okay? So, unahin natin deposit type. Okay? Savings, special savings, demand or check, demand deposits or checking accounts. Mga now or negotiable order of withdrawals and time deposits. Okay, these are deposits that are covered by PDIC. Okay? Mamaya magpapakita rin tayo ng mga hindi covered. Okay? By deposit amount, okay? Single accounts meaning ikaw lang yung may-ari, wala ka nang ibang kahati doon sa account na 'yon. Okay, and then joint. And then, yung mga buy in trust for account of. Okay? Mamaya, i-discuss rin natin yan kung ano ba yung mga yan. Okay? And then, of course, by currency. Okay? So, pwedeng Philippine peso, pwedeng foreign currency. As long as these banks have operations here in the Philippines, whether they are domestic or foreign banks. Okay? Ano yung mga not covered? Okay? Investment products such as bonds and securities, trust accounts, and other similar instruments. Okay? Because these are not deposits. Okay? Investment products hindi kasama. Okay? Deposit accounts or transactions that are, ayan, unfunded, fictitious, or fraudulent. Okay? So, syempre, if a, although the bank is covered, it's a member of the PDIC, okay, pasok siya sa mga accounts na yan, by deposit type, by deposit amount, or by currency. Yun nga lang, they are fictitious, they are fraudulent, they are unfunded, hindi siya maisasali. Hindi siya bibigyan ng PDIC ng deposit insurance. Okay? Deposit accounts or transactions that constitute unsafe and unsound banking practices. O, yun na nga yung sabi natin kanina. As provided by an issuance by the PDIC called the PDIC Regulatory Issuance Number 2011-01. Okay? Ayan. Ayan. In consultation with the BSP after due notice and hearing and publication of PDIC cease and desist order. Kasi, yun nga, gaya na sabi ko kanina, banks that engage in unsafe and unsound banking practices, they are first and foremost warned and then given corrective actions. Pero kung hindi pa rin, pwede siyang mauwi sa cease and desist order. You must stop your operations as a bank. Okay? And then, pwede rin ma-remove yung membership ng PDIC and therefore yung mga depositors hindi siya magiging walang deposit insurance. Okay? And deposit accounts or transactions that are determined to be proceeds of unlawful activity as defined in Anti-Money Laundering Act. Yung mga predicate crimes na nilista natin, there are 14 or 15 of them, okay, listed under the Anti-Money Laundering Act, which we discussed last time. Okay, if they are proceeds of, or if an account is found out to be a proceed, is found out to be, you know, pinaglagyan ng mga proceeds from unlawful activity, like for example, kidnap for ransom, okay, in-split, nilagay sa different accounts, if those accounts are found out to be, you know, yun nga, holding funds that are from unlawful activity, adi hindi rin sila bibigyan ng deposit insurance, those, yan na, dyan na magiging hand-in-hand itong mga different na batas na ito. So, AMLA is going to seize all of these funds. Kasi ano bang nangyayari sa mga funds which are found out to be laundered? Okay? They will be seized and then they will be turned over to the government, in favor of the government. Okay? Ganun din dito. If they are taken away by the AMLA, okay, to be given in favor of the government, does that mean that that account will be, in case of the closure of a bank na pinaglagyan ng unlawful, proceeds ng unlawful activity, makakakuha ba sila ng deposit insurance? Of course, hindi. Okay, galing sa masama yung pera na nakalagay doon. Bakit natin sila bibigyan ng deposit insurance? Okay? So, ayun. Makukuha na ngayong pera, makukulong pa yung mga culprits nitong money laundering na ito. Okay? Ayan, not covered bank deposits in foreign banks operating outside the Philippines. Yun nga, kasi sabi natin kanina, hindi sila covered. Ang covered lang, those that have operations here in the Philippines, whether domestic man yan o foreign. Basta merong operations dito sa Pilipinas. Okay? Bank deposits in foreign branch of domestic banks operating outside the Philippines. So, ganun din. Even if deposit ang isang banko, they are incorporated under Philippine laws. Kung meron silang foreign branches and yung deposit mo nandun sa foreign branch na yon, hindi siya na naman magiging covered ng PDIC. Hindi sila mabibigyan ng deposit insurance. Okay? And ito na, yung risk. What is the risk that is being covered by the PDIC? Only risk of a bank closure ordered by the monetary board. If, yun na nga, sabi dito, kung due to theft, fire, closure by reason of strike or existence of public disorder, revolution or civil war, hindi siya covered ng PDIC because the only thing na i-cover, yun nga, bank closure ordered by the BSP through its monetary board. Okay? So, yung nabalitaan natin dati na may nakawan na nangyari sa, I think, anong bank ba yun? Metro Bank, dyan sa malapit sa katedral. Okay? Yung mga account holders na yon, they are not insured. Okay? Pero syempre, ano naman, if you lose kasi 'di ba nga may debtor and creditor relationship ang isang bank tsaka isang account holder. If a generic thing is lost, okay? Sabi nga naman natin, 'di ba, genus non quam perit, okay? Or genus never perishes. Ang money is a generic thing eh. Kahit pa sabihin mong 1,000 peso bill with serial number ganito ganyan. Okay? Generic pa rin ang pera. So, genus never perishes and therefore the obligation between the bank and the account holder is still not extinguished. Okay, hindi siya ma-extinguish. Okay, the obligation is still there. Okay? It still subsists. Okay? So yun nga, yung account andun pa rin. So wala namang risk, okay, on the part of the account holder. Okay, hindi naman nawala yung pera niya talaga. But yun nga, in case of bank closure, edi tigil operation na eh. Yung account mo nandun, wala na. Dahil tigil ng operations, you might not be able to recover it. So, kailangan, yun nga, magkaroon ka ng, I mean, kailangan may ma-receive ka. Okay, kasi nga, nag-close yung banko and nag-cease yung operations. So, yun nga, mga account holders dapat may ma-receive sila. Okay? So, again, tandaan ninyo, bank closure lang, na ordered by the monetary board. Yun lang ang covered. Okay, ito na yung sa, ano, PDIC, or, ano yun? Yung PDIC Regulatory Issuance number 2011-01, okay, provides for the unsafe and unsound deposit-related activities. Okay? So, number one, deposit-related practice, activity, or transaction without the approval or adequate controls required under existing laws, rules, and regulations. Okay, failure to keep bank records within bank premises. Okay? And then, granting high interest rates. Okay? Non-compliance with PDIC regulations. So, yun na yung sinasabi natin kanina. The third mandate of the PDIC is, yun nga, co-regulator sila ng banks together with the BSP, together with the Banko Sentral ng Pilipinas. Okay? So, if there is non-compliance with PDIC regulations, yun nga, they can be subject to cease and desist order. Ipapasara yung bank. Okay? Ayan na. How are we going to compute for the deposit insurance? Okay? Pero before that, we have to know muna ano bang single accounts, ano ba yung joint, okay, and yung mga special na accounts, no? So, single accounts, these are individually owned accounts or accounts held under one name, okay? Pero syempre, the owners of single accounts are persons, either natural or juridical persons, okay? So, natural persons tayo, okay? And for purposes of determining the nature of an account, okay, single proprietors are considered natural persons. So, for example, I am an individual person, meron akong account sa isang bangko, and since I am a firm believer of the business entity concept, which you have learned in your CFAS, okay, edi, ayun, gumawa ako ng sariling account sa same bank, okay, pero separate. Okay, para kapag gusto kong gumawa ng capital investments, I just make a fund transfer from my personal account papunta dun sa business accounts. Okay? Pero, yun nga, hindi nag-a-apply yan dito sa PDIC law. Okay? Yung account ko sa isang bank personally and yung account ng sole proprietorship na pagmamayari ko, it will be combined. Okay? Because single proprietors will be considered natural persons. Titignan, sino bang owner? Okay? Juridical entities, okay? Partnership, corporations, cooperatives. Okay? And meron tayong rules doon sa juridical entity later. So, since they are persons, makaka-receive din sila ng ano. These juridical entities will also be able to receive parts of parts ng insured deposits, okay? Ng, for example, joint accounts, okay? Ayan, joint accounts. Ito naman, yung kapag merong and or kaya and or joint accounts yung mga yan. Okay, so illustrative example, okay, for example, si Andy Lim, tsaka ang account name is Andy Lim or Kenneth C. Okay, at ang balance, if they are to present their passbook, makikita na ang kanilang balance is 500,000 pesos. Okay, how much is the share of Andy Lim? Okay, syempre 250,000, because the general rule in joint accounts is paghahatian yan equally unless there is a different division scheme. Okay, kung may iba pa mang sharing, okay, scheme, which is indicated in their deposit papers. Okay, pero kung nakalagay, sinabi na ano, nung nag-open sila ng account, nakalagay na si Andy Lim e 20% lang ang kanya, di 100,000 lang ang share niya. Pero if silent, equal. Okay? Second example, account name is Andy Lim and something Wong. Ah, bakit? Ah, yeah. Okay. Magkano ang share ni Andy Lim doon sa deposit na yon? 500,000. Okay, ang kanyang share. Kasi nga, 1 million yung deposit, 1 million yung balance eh. Ang kay Andy Lim dyan, 500,000. Ang kay Something Wong dyan, 500,000 din. But, since meron na siyang 250,000 dun sa naunang account, okay, assuming that this is, or these accounts are found in one single bank, okay, then, 250 na lang yung pwede niyang makuhang insured deposit. Okay? Yung pangalawa, ay yung pangatlo, Andy Lim and or Kelly T. Okay? 1 million, 500,000 na naman ang kay Andy Lim, 500,000 na naman yung kay Kelly T. But, wala siyang insured deposit dyan sa account na yan dahil puno na. 500,000 na yung maximum eh. Okay, what if all these three accounts are placed in different banks? Okay, e di makukuha nila yung buo. And yung una, 250,000 makukuha ni Andy Lim. Yung pangalawa, 500. Yung pangatlo, 500. Okay? Because they are in different banks. Kasi nga, ang rule natin, 500,000 na maximum deposit per depositor per bank. Okay? Kaya the best way talaga, if you are a depositor, you do not place your eggs in one basket. Okay? I-diversify mo. Lagay mo sa iba't ibang mga banko. Okay? Para if something wrong happens, no, edi ma-maximize yung marerecover natin. Okay? Pero yun nga, since they are, if we are to assume that they are, these three accounts are found in one bank only, okay, edi yun. Maximum of 500 lang sa lahat ng tatlong accounts na yan. Okay? And you have to also remember, guys, that when we say bank, it includes all the branches. So if, for example, itong tatlong accounts na ito, yung unang account is in BPI Tanza Junction, yung pangalawang account is in BPI Palengke, okay, Mall of the Valley, yung pangatlo nasa BPI College Avenue, okay, it will still be considered as one bank only. Hindi mo siya paghihiwa-hiwalayin. Okay? So, in that case, 500,000 pa rin yung total na insured deposit ni Andy Lim. Ito na. Yung mga buy na to, ITF or 4 accounts, ITF or FAO, in trust 4 or 4 account of, okay? These are to be considered, it depends, no? Pwedeng single, pwedeng joint. Okay? Pero in these examples, given in your PowerPoint presentation, all of these are single accounts, no? Kasi kunwari Anna by Ben. Okay? Anna is the depositor. So, isa lang. Okay, kung Anna and ganito by ganito, di Anna and whoever, okay? Joint na 'yon, okay? Kapag in trust for, okay? Anna in trust for Ben, ibig sabihin si Ben ang depositor and Anna is the trustee. Okay? And then, for the account of, okay, or for example, Anna for the account of Ben, Ben again is the depositor. So, si Ben ang may insured deposit dyan. Okay, isipin na lang ninyo kung buy yung una. Okay, kasi isang syllable lang yung buy. Okay, kapag hindi isang syllable, in trust for the account of, oh, hindi siya one syllable, yung pangalawa na. Okay? minsan meron talaga tayo mga nonsense na ano eh, na pampa-remember lang ng mga bagay-bagay. Okay? Like for example, holding period. O sino lang ba ang pwedeng magkaroon ng holding period sa dealings in properties? O diba, syempre, mga natural persons. I mean, individuals lang. Okay? Pwede silang magkaroon ng net capital loss carryover. Pwede silang magkaroon ng holding period. Kasi, they have hands. Natural persons, meron silang mga kamay. So, generally, they have hands. So, they can hold. Corporations are not subject kasi nga, they are juridical persons only. Wala silang mga kamay. So, hindi sila pwede mag-hold. Walang holding period. Okay? O kaya, when his means permit me to do so, is that an obligation with period or an obligation with a condition? Okay? That is actually, an obligation with a period because your means is a period. Your means is a period. Okay? Minsan, meron talaga mga nonsense na pampaalala. So, ganito rin dito. Okay? By, one syllable lang siya, una. Okay? In trust for, FAO, not one syllable, yung pangalawa. Okay? Or hindi yung una. Okay? Yung pangalawa. Sila yung depositor. Okay? Another illustrative example. Okay? So, tignan natin si Andilim ulit ang ating bida. Okay? First account, Andilim. Okay? Siya lang. It's a single account. 100,000 yung deposit. How much is insured in that account? The entire 100,000. Okay? Pangalawa, Kenneth C for account of Andilim. O, di ba? Pag for account of, ang depositor yung pangalawa. So, si Andilim. Okay? 100,000 ang deposit. Ibig sabihin, ang insured, entire 100. So, a total cumulative balance is 200,000 na. Okay? Yung pangatlo, something wrong in trust of Andilim. Okay? 100,000 ulit. So, insured na naman lahat yan kasi hindi mo pa naman nabubuo yung 500,000. So, running balance is 300,000 na. And then lastly, Andilim Optical Clinic, which is a sole proprietorship. Sabi natin kanina, sole proprietorship will be considered a natural person. So, Andilim Optical Clinic, titingnan ko sinong may-ari, edi si Andilim. And, it's a single account. Therefore, although 700,000 yung deposit niya, ang insured na lang is 200 kasi may 300 ka na dun sa ibang accounts mo. Provided that all of these accounts are found in one bank. Kung naghiwa-hiwalay na naman yan, di hiwa-hiwalay ulit. Okay? 100,000 dun sa una, 100,000 sa pangalawa, 100,000 sa pangatlo, and sa pang-apat, yung sa optical clinic, 500. Okay? If these are in different banks. Pero dito kasi, in this case, we find all of these four accounts sa isang banko lang. So, the total consolidated balances should be until 500,000 lang. Hanggang dun lang ang insured. Okay? Ito na. Joint accounts, no? The general rule is that the insured, nasabi ko na yan kanina, okay? In a joint account, it is divided equally unless different sharing scheme is stipulated in the deposit papers, okay, or the deposit documents. Okay? So, these are joint accounts. Ang kanyang total insured deposit is 500. These are singular accounts. Ang total insured deposit na naman niya is 500,000. So, question, how much is Andilim's insured deposit for all his single and joint accounts? The answer is 1 million pesos minus all obligations or loans of the depositor with the closed bank. Why? Kasi nga, we are to account separately yung mga singular accounts and yung mga joint accounts natin. So, if you have a single account, you have joint accounts pa, hanggang 500 dun sa single, hanggang 500 dun sa joint account. So, yung total deposit that you can have insured is 1 million pesos per depositor per bank if you have joint and single accounts. Pero if you only have single accounts, 500 lang per depositor per bank. Okay? Okay, ito na. Once we have known how it is computed, no, yung insured deposits. By the way, no, in your exams, which will be on Friday, there will be questions wherein you will have to supply magkano ba yung insurance, yung deposit insurance. Okay. Siguro yung mga questions sa PDIC will revolve on, yun nga, on that. Computation, magkano ba ang maximum insurance deposit na pwede makuha ng isang depositor? And of course, some theories. Okay? Gaya nito, requirements, okay? And others, yung mga napag-usapan na natin kanina. Okay? So, ayan. Once we have known sino ang covered, and if you are covered, how much, and now that you know how much, how are we going to claim? Okay? So, ayan. When are you going to file the claims? Okay? By the way, meron tayong ano, no, claim form which you can download doon sa website ng PDIC, pdic.gov.ph. Okay? And when are you going to file claims? Okay? Kasi nga, there will be a notice, okay, to depositors which will be placed in newspapers of general circulation. It will also be placed in the PDIC website and in conspicuous places in the vicinity of the bank. So that, syempre, if you're going to transact business with a bank, syempre, pupunta ka naman dun sa branch. So at least in conspicuous places, dun sa kitang-kita, dun sa obvious na obvious sa'yo, para walang reason of misinformation. Okay? So once you have known, once it is known to you, na magsasara na yung bangko or na nagsara na nga yung bangko by order of the Monetary Board of the BSP, you are to give or you are to file your claims, okay? And you have 2 years, okay, from the PDIC takeover to file, okay, yung mga deposit insurance claims. File lang ito, ha, hindi pa ito receiving of the claims, okay? Magfa-file ka pa lang, okay? So if before yung requirements, no, kasi meron ka pang kailangan mga i-prepare, no, but before that, who are required to file deposit insurance claims? Those that have balances of more than 100,000, you are required to file deposit insurance claims. Those who have outstanding obligations, okay, regardless of amount. So even if you are below 100,000, if you have outstanding obligations, then you still have to file, okay? Kasi nga, isasama yan sa computation ng ibibigay sa'yo. Okay? And then, next, depositors with less than 100 na hindi updated yung addresses in the bank records. Okay? And yun nga, who have no updated addresses in the bank records, okay? Or who have not updated their addresses through the MAUF. And the MAUF is the mailing address update form. Okay? Kasi it's possible that you will be paid... hindi, kasi yung PDIC will be mailing you. So, kailangan nire-require ng PDIC na either you have updated your addresses in the bank records, or kung hindi naman, pwede rin naman through the MAUF issued by the PDIC. Kasi yun nga, yung bank records, aanhin pa ng banko yun, nagsara naman na. So pwedeng, since the PDIC takes over, it will take the records of the bank, and in addition to that, the records of the PDIC itself, okay, through the MAUF or the mailing address update form. Okay? So, next, depositors who maintain their accounts under the name of business entities, okay, regardless of type of account or account balance. So, those who have sole proprietorships, who are partners, who are shareholders in a corporation or members in a cooperative, okay, kailangan mo ring mag-file. And then, depositors with accounts not eligible for early payment. Okay, itong early payment kasi nito, these are those who are under 100,000. Kasi nga, the PDIC wants to protect the small depositors as well. Hindi lang yung mga malalaki. Kaya nga, yung mga maliliit na depositors, there is a huge chance na buo yung mare-receive nila. Kasi nga, hindi nila na-meet yung threshold na 500,000. But if you are a big depositor, let's say 15 million ang account, ang pera mo sa banko, you're only insured up to 500,000. So, malaking lugi yan on your part. So, lumalabas na the PDIC is trying to protect, okay, yung mga maliliit na businesses and accounts, okay? And yun nga, sila rin yung eligible for early payment. Sila rin yung pinaprioritize. Not required. Okay? If you have 100,000 and below, you're not required. If you don't have obligations and if you have updated your address, wala nang kailangan ang PDIC sa'yo. So, you are not required to file deposit insurance claims. Okay? Steps in filing, you prepare documents, then you submit personally doon sa office ng PDIC sa Makati or pwede rin naman through mail. Okay, what are you going to prepare? Okay, original evidence of deposits like passbooks, etc. Okay, one valid photo bearing ID with clear signature. Okay, as long as the ID has your ID and signature. Okay, and that signature must be clear kasi very strict ang mga banko with signatures. Okay? Kahit pa ikaw talaga ang pumirma diyan pero hindi nagkatugma, okay? Pwedeng i-deny yung payment sa iyo. Okay? Original birth certificate coming from the Philippine Statistics Authority if you are below 18. And original copy of notarized special power of attorney for claimants who are not signatories in the bank records. Okay? And then you submit personally or through mail. Okay? And it must be attached pala by with the deposit insurance claim form which you could download nga doon sa pdic.gov.ph. And who should sign? If you are a single account holder and you are 18 and above, then you sign the deposit insurance claim form. If you are a minor, then your parents must co-sign. Okay, they must sign your deposit insurance form. Agent must sign if it is a buy account. Okay, trustee kapag ITF, and then since these are joint accounts, all of the co-owners of that account. Okay, each of the depositors. So that's it for PDIC law. Ito lang naman yung kailangan ninyong tandaan talaga. So okay, na-establish na merong deposit insurance, who are covered. Okay? Once we know who are covered, paano natin kukompyutin yung deposit insurance ng mga covered na to? And then after that, how are they going to claim? And when are they going to claim? Okay, yun lang naman ang kailangan natin tandaan. So, thank you very much for listening. Your exams will be on Friday, and it will contain 50 items, all multiple choice. Okay? So, yun lang naman. Thank you very much for listening again, and we will have one final session which will cover yung unclaimed balances tsaka yung bank secrecy. Okay, have a nice rest of the evening. Thank you.